Hello! We can now see styrofoam being cut with a hot wire. Notice how thick and straight the edges of the styrofoam can be obtained with a self-made cutter. The worktop is made from the sides of an old wardrobe. On the sides of the top from the bottom, there are wooden squares screwed with screws. The slats straightened the wavy surface of the old plywood and also made it possible to mount the guide arms to the top. The tabletop stands on three low legs. Under the tabletop there is a place for a rectifier for charging the batteries, which warms up the wire. The straight line movement of the cutter arms is ensured by two ball bearing slides for drawers 50 cm long. The arms are made of wooden squares of appropriate length, thanks to which the maximum cutting height is 50.5 cm, which allows me to cut through the entire package of polystyrene. The upper wooden beam is screwed to the vertical arms. The connections are reinforced with self-made angle bars made of 0.5 mm galvanized sheet. A wire is attached to the bottom of the movable arm together with a tension spring left over from the disassembly of the mattress. The cutting wire is located below the surface of the worktop in the slot. The length of the worktop and the cutting wire allows for a diagonal cutting of a standard polystyrene board 100 cm by 50 cm. The connection of the cutting wire with the power cord is made in such a way that the tension spring does not heat up. Flexible power cords were nailed with cables ties to the wooden arms. The cables were obtained from an old washing machine. The decisive factor was the large cross section, not the color. The wires are connected with crocodile clips to the rectifier wires, which are isolated from the ground with rubber bands from old bicycle inner tubes. The charger is connected by a cable to an extension cord with a switch. The device is turned on by this switch. The appropriate repeatable length and angle of the cut is ensured by a wooden locating bar with marks every 10 cm made with an angle grinder and an easily movable stop with a 10 cm ruler. On the tabletop, marks were made for the cutting line at an angle of every 15 degrees by cutting a recess with a friction disc and filling it with silicone. For a perfect cut line, the lightweight polystyrene sheet must be secured by the weight against movement. The cutting wire must be heated to the appropriate temperature so that the cutting time is as short as possible and the cutting surface soft. Using a wire that is too hot shortens the cutting time, but at the same time causes an increased emission of harmful polystyrene fumes and the formation of a hard and brittle coating at the cutting site. The rectifier I have has the ability to adjust the current intensity, thanks to which it is possible to change the power supply to the cutting element. Due to the low voltage supplied by the rectifier, 14 volt, I had to use a 1.2 mm thick wire for cutting. For 0.6 mm wire, I would need to purchase a power supply of at least 24 volts. To increase the accuracy of a long vertical cut, I added two additional external sliding guides. I made them myself from 0.5 mm galvanized sheet. I use a spring clamp to protect the guides from falling down when loading a sheet of polystyrene onto the worktop. The cost of materials for the presented tool was $20. Be aware, however, that the use of such tool involves the risk of electric shock, fire, burns, or inhalation of harmful fumes. Therefore, it's not a tool that anyone can build and use. When buying a professional polystyrene cutter, read the manufacturer's instruction before buying. In what condition you must not use it? because you may not be able to meet them. The presented device lacks a normally open foot switch, which would facilitate work and reduce the risk of fire and burn out of the wire. I am Silvestro. I invite you to like the video and share your opinions in the comments below it. I invite you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and watch other films.